the FOMO?
Vlog time. I'm going to Philly to do some vlogging.
So precious is yours, is mine, only one at a time. So precious is yours, is mine, only one at a time. My life, my life.
You definitely seen the Make It Home Safely event where we popped up in Philly. We had a really good time. It was so much fun. All the information of who sponsored and put on this show, put on this event, is down below. Super duper dope content, dope information. There was an actual therapist there.
I don't know if you guys can see my sweater, but it says you matter, because you definitely do matter.
There was a therapist there. His information will be here. And we definitely had a really great conversation. I don't know if you guys know, but I lost my father about 10 years ago. This actually makes the 10-year mark. And I don't think I really grieved how I possibly could have grieved. I lost him when I was 16, right after my 16th birthday party. It was really hard for me because I felt like I had to be strong for like my mom, my grandmother, and there was a lot of drama that happened around his death. And so I didn't really grieve properly. And so like I was talking to the therapist about grieving, and he gave me some tips. So I'm gonna share them with you guys. So the therapist basically shared some tips with me on like grieving. And so he was like, definitely see a therapist. Talk to somebody about it. Talk therapy is really, really important. And if you can't afford or you're not comfortable with talking to somebody, he gave me these two strategies you can use. You can like write in a journal and say, well, like June 5th, I feel so-and-so. Or, you know, just write it down how you feel. You don't even have to be consistent with it. You can just write down how you feel that day. If you are having like a rough day or you're thinking really heavy on that person, you can just write about it. And then just keep it as like documentary and just write down how you feel that day or in that moment about that person. He's like, that could be therapeutic. And then also, if you're not like a writer, let's say like, maybe you have dyslexia or you're just not a writer in general, voice record yourself and just say how you feel. Like, today I was in the park and I saw so-and-so and it made me feel this way. That's a way of therapy, just being able to express yourself, even if nobody hears it. Oh, and then one more bonus tip that he gave is that he said that he lost somebody when he was pretty young in his teenage years. And what he did was he wrote a letter to that person who passed away. And I really think that's really important, because like when my father passed away, I was really hurt. And I felt a little abandoned, which manifests itself in different ways in my life now. But I definitely am going to take that into consideration and, like, write a note and just tell my dad basically, like, how I felt during the situation, how I feel now. If the person you're dating or you're interested in dating isn't interested in, like, working on themselves and bettering themselves, you have to take a step back and say, okay, is this conducive to the work that I put in? Will this set me back or will this move me forward? And you have to, like, evaluate and see, like, should I move forward with this person even though I know that they're not on the same, like, wavelength as I am? And just do some self-evaluation. So it was really good information. I definitely advise you to check him out. Again, all his information will be somewhere here. And I really had a great time at the Get Home Safe event. They're going to be doing events, and they definitely do events in D.C. This is their first event in Philly. It was really great, and they should be moving out to the Baltimore area and beyond very soon. So definitely check out for them. This is like the middle of the vlog. It's definitely going on. I don't know if you guys can hear in the background, but like, it's lit downstairs. So I'm about to go to that. Stay tuned for the rest of the vlog.
Left Max because the line was way too long, but y'all already know I'm like, I'm a vegan, so I didn't really, I'm not eating any of that. So we went to this new place called Cabibbles, I don't know, but we about to get some Philly cheesesteak. Well, they are. I'm good.
Number three.
I'm gonna be here.